And then to make you recite, that is our duty. Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that I used to sit in the majlis of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and I used to forget. He came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, Abu Huraira, take out your shawl. Take your shawl out. Abu Huraira takes his shawl out. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam takes his hand. He makes it into a cup and he puts it into the shawl of Abu Huraira. And he says, Abu Huraira, take this shawl and put it around you now. Abu Huraira says, from that day I never forgot anything. He narrated the most amount of hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The governor of the time, he calls Abu Huraira. He wants to assess the memory of Abu Huraira. He calls Abu Huraira and he tells Abu Huraira that you're going to narrate hadith from me. He puts a barrier, a veil, and he puts someone behind, a scribe. He tells him, you make a note of all the hadith that Abu Huraira reads from memory. The scribe makes a note of all the hadith. 1 year later, he calls Abu Huraira back. He says, Abu Huraira, you know, last year you recited some hadith to me. Can you recite them again? He puts the scribe again there. In the same manner that Abu Huraira read 1 year ago, again he recited it.
Subhanallah.
Imam Bukhari, rahmatullah alayhi, his memory of hadith. The people of Baghdad, they wanted to test him. 10 different people were taken, 10 different hadith. One is you get the text of hadith and then you get the narrators of hadith. Everything was mixed up. They changed it. And all the people, they gathered, they heard about Imam Bukhari, and the person starts to narrate the first hadith, second hadith. 100 hadith are read. Each hadith they ask, Bukhari, have you heard this hadith? He says, no. Have you heard this hadith? He says, no. Have you heard this? He says, no. Awam, you and I, general masses, what they know? They said, huh? People were talking about him. 100 hadiths were read. He doesn't know them. After 100 people finish, then Bukhari says, you read the first one like this. This is how it's supposed to be. You read the second one like this. This is how it's supposed to be. You read the third one. This is where you went wrong. This is how it's supposed to be. 100 hadith he recited exactly as they read, and then he recited the correct manner to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one that reveals the Quran, he is the one that preserves the Quran. We are going very, very far away. There's no need to go that far away. You look at Shaykhul Hind rahmatullah alayh, Shaykhul Islam rahmatullah alayh, Hazrat Mawlana Hussain Ahmad Badni rahmatullah alayh. He was traveling, he was in the prison in Malta with his sheikh, and no one to perform Salatul Taraweeh. There was no Hafzul Quran. So what he does, every day he memorizes one juz of the Quran. Come night time, he performs that juz of the Quran memory from memory. Mufti Taqi Usmani has written a incident in his book regarding one muhaddith. The muhaddith says, you know, there's two things I just cannot comprehend how I did those two things. He says, one is, I know in excess of 100,000 hadith, yet I am not a hafiz of Quran. Ek lag se zyada hafiz hadith yaad hai, lekin main hafiz nahi hoon. So he says, one day he sat down after Salatul Fajr, Isha ka time aa gaya, Allah made him hafiz of Quran. Fajr se Isha ek din mein, the memory that Allah gave, and the miracle of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second incident that he mentions, I wouldn't want you to try and do that. You know, sometimes they say, don't do this at home. So he says, I took my beard and I was going to cut in excess of what was under my fist. I don't know how I did it, but I took the scissor, I put it here, and I cut whatever was above my fist. So alhamdulillah, like I said to you, there's no need now for us to go out of the country, in our very own country. Allah has brought the day when in our own country the institutions have opened. And mashallah, you know, they are exceeding ulama from outside also. When they come, they are also perplexed as to how well the madaris are progressing here. I told the brothers from Brazil, from Jamaat, I say, I have an advice for you. Come tomorrow for the program. I will introduce you to Hazrat Maulana Ismail Sahib. You all have children there in your country. Send your children here, make them kuffars, make them ulama, and they will work back there. Sheikh Imran told me, in Brazil, He says one of the main reasons why people are so far from deen. I've been to Turkey, one of the main reasons. And even in the Middle Eastern countries, the Arab states, one of the main reasons is that what? We have abandoned the teaching of the Quran to the young children. The makatib, the maktab is the backbone. If you will teach your children the Quran in the masjid, you will teach them in the madrasa, they will be the future flag bearers of deen and Islam. So we have with us here from Darul Uloom Leicester, student by the name of Hafiz Inayatul Haq, who is the son of Mawlana Shaheedul Haq Sahab. Allah has gifted him with this ni'mat. Say, MashaAllah.
MashaAllah.
That you ask him from the Quran, ask him the page number, and he will be able